Hi all, welcome to the next session on commodity derivatives and risk management. And as you recall, we discussed how the spot and futures price must converge on the contract expiry date. In today's session, we will discuss more about the commodity basis risk. So let's first understand what do we mean by basis, or what is the definition of basis. Basis is defined as the difference between the spot price and futures price at a given point of time. Let me repeat, basis is defined as the difference between the spot price and the futures price prevailing at a given point of time. Many textbooks or many websites you may come across where they may define basis as future price minus the spot price, but our discussion, it is a basis is the spot price minus the futures price. Now let's go to a little bit on contango market. So my question to all of you is, in case of a contango market, whether basis is going to be positive or negative? Okay, the answer to my question is the basis is going to be negative in case of a contango market. So as mentioned in this particular slide, you have a commodity basis on DT, that let's define it as BT. So BT is the spot price minus the futures price prevailing on the DT, and basis is normally goes down as the delivery approaches and spot and futures price converge on the maturity date. If you recall, as we discussed in the last class, spot and futures price converge. So whenever the spot and futures price is converging, you will have a basis which is going down. So contracts which have longer time to maturity will have a higher value of basis as compared to contracts which are near the maturity. And in fact, theoretically speaking, on the contract maturity date, basis should come to zero. Now, as we discussed, basis is negative in the contango market and basis will be positive in a backwardation market. And you know that futures price is higher than the spot price in case of a contango market, so that gives rise to negative basis for contango market and positive basis for backwardation market. Let's focus on this graph, the picture which is given in this slide. So if you see this particular, at this point of time, you have spot is less than the futures contract. So the spot is higher than the futures contract. So this is the place where you will have a backwardation market, and after some point of time you will have futures becoming more than the spot, and this is the place where you have a contango market, so on and so forth. So you can have spot and futures price can move from contango to backwardation or vice versa before the contract maturity, but as the contract matures, so this tip of the diagram, both the pictures, this shows the contract maturity date on which both spot and futures price converge, leading to zero basis. Now in this context, let's understand what do you mean by strengthening a basis or weakening a basis. So as we discussed, for a contango market you will always have a negative basis. So as the time progresses, this negative basis can be more negative or can be less negative. A positive basis can be more positive or less positive. So when we are talking about strengthening a basis, so this particular picture very clearly indicates. So when we are talking strengthening a basis, changes from more negative to less negative and from less positive to more positive. So let's say if basis is minus 25 on the contract initiation date, and at a later point of time basis reduces to minus 5, we will say strengthening of basis. And similarly, suppose on a contract initiation date basis was 5 rupees and at a later point of time basis increased to 20 or 25 rupees, we will say strengthening of basis. So this RO, so minus to more minus to less minus, or less positive to more positive, is your strengthening of basis. And what is weakening of basis? It is other way around, from more positive to less positive, or from less negative to more negative. So if the basis is moving from more positive to less positive, or less negative to more negative, it is known as a weakening of the basis. So with this, let's understand how basis is an important risk for commodity futures trader. This is a very, very important concept which all of us must understand thoroughly, because that is the essence of futures trading. So how do we define basis risk? Basis risk is defined as the risk that the value of the futures contract will not move in line with that of the underlying exposure. That is, the spot market prices are moving in some direction while the futures contract may move in the same direction or may not move in the same direction. So if the basis changes, basis becomes more wide or less wide, basis strengthens or basis weakens, that is going to give rise to a risk to the commodity futures trader. Now let's take an example to understand how this basis, how basis is calculated and how basis is a risk for commodity futures trader. Before I go into this Excel file, I would like to again remind you what is the difference between a long hedger and a short hedger. Maybe quite a few substantial number of times I am saying this, short hedger and which is a long hedger, because this is my way of probably reinforcing this very valuable concept of the difference between long hedger and a short hedger. So who is a short hedger? Short hedger is a party who is owning the asset, and that party's fear is that price is going to go down unless he does something. So he enters into a contract, the trader enters into a contract to sell the underlying or take a short futures position, hence he is a short hedger. Now let's take an example of how basis risk is affecting a short hedger. So you have, I hope you are able to see the screen properly. So you have a hedger, the left side is the hedger takes a short position on 23rd April 2016. So on spot date is your 23rd April 2016, and the hedger is entering into a contract which is maturing on May 2016, and he would like to square up his short futures position on 3rd May 2016. Why would he be interested in squaring up his position on 3rd May 2016? Because the hedger who is who is producing soya oil, he has already committed to deliver the underlying on 3rd May. So he will be as per its cash market operation, he will be delivering the underlying, and he does not need to keep its futures position open beyond this date. So he would be he is interested to square up the short futures position which he has taken on 22nd April 2016 on 3rd May 2016. Now let's say let's say on the spot date, that is 23rd April 2016, what is the difference, what is the spot and futures price prevailing? The spot price is 100 rupees and the futures price is 20 rupees. So going by our definition of basis, spot price minus the futures price, so you have a negative basis because it's a contango market, and basis is also defined as spot minus futures. So 100 minus 20 is your 20 minus 20, so you have a basis as 20 rupees. Now let's go to the next day. Let's, we ignore what is happening in the spot market, so we don't care what is, we do care what is happening, but that is not required. This information is not required at this point of time for understanding the impact of basis risk. Now let's go to, let's say this next day, that is on 24th April, the futures price goes down by 1 rupee. So when futures price goes down by 1 rupee, the trader has taken short futures, so he is benefiting when the futures price goes down. So his gain is, mark to market gain is 1 rupee. So or margin gain, margin receipt or margin margin gain, what he is getting is 1 rupee. Similarly, all these days 1111 rupees futures price is going down, so every day he is getting 11 rupees. So at the end of the, that is 3rd May, on 3rd May, what is the net benefit on account of a margin receipt? He is getting 20 rupees. Now let's say he is going to sell the underlying asset at the prevailing spot market price. So what has he done? That he goes to the market and he finds out that the prevailing price has gone down, which is his fear. 100 rupees has gone down to 90 rupees, so he would be selling the underlying asset in the market at 90 rupees. However, he will be getting 10 rupees as its profit from the futures contract, resulting in a net receipt, total receipt of 100 rupees. So, this is one case. Let's go to the next case. Let's say instead of futures price going down by 11 rupees, let's say futures price increases by 11 rupees. So, what is happening? 120, 120, 122, so on and so forth. So futures price is increased to 130, and every day he is, because futures price is increasing, he will be paying mark to market margin. So his net receipt is going to be minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So sum total of it, that is coming to a minus 10. And on the contract expiry date or physical transaction date, the spot price, contrary to his expectation of decline price, price has gone up to 110. So he will be selling the underlying asset in the market at 110, but simultaneously he has already paid 10 rupees as a mark to market loss. So his net receipt is going to be 100 rupees. In fact, if you see the previous example which I gave and the current example, the basis has not changed. Basis has remained minus 20 and minus 20 here. And so in both cases, basis has remained unchanged. And what is his net receipt? Net receipt is the proceed which he is going to get by selling the asset in the underlying market, plus any net receipt from the futures market through the margin. Of course, we are ignoring the initial margin part of it, because initial margin is a deposit which the trader, both buyers and sellers of futures contract, pay, and they get it back at the end of the when the square of the contract, when they square the contract. So this is margin, initial margin payment or receipt does not in any way get influenced or gets factored into this calculation. Now this total receipt is also, if you can see, total receipt is 90 plus 10, that is a spot market price plus the margin receipt. This total receipt is also nothing but the futures price committed on contracted on day 0 plus the basis prevailing on the contract square of date. So 120 minus 20 is going to give you a total receipt of 100. Now let's take other situations. So we have taken a contango situation. Let's take a backwardation situation where you have a spot is 100 and futures is 20, futures is 80. Similarly, the futures price is increasing 1111 rupees, and it is from 80 to 90 it is increasing, and the spot price is also increasing. So, giving rise to 20 as a basis both on the contract signing date and the contract squaring up date. So, because the futures price is increasing, this long short futures holder will pay 1 rupee margin. So, net receipt is going to be minus 10, and he will be selling the underlying at a higher price of 110, and his net receipt is going to be 100. Now let's go to the again the same situation. You know, you have a backwardation market 180, and instead of futures price increasing, futures price is going down by 11 rupees every day. So that is also resulting in net receipt of 100 rupees when this particular party sells the underlying in the spot market, and also adjusts for the margin receipt or margin payment. Now let's go to the situation when you have the basis moves in a different manner. We start with 100 and 120. It is a contango market. Basis is minus 20. But if you see on the contract maturity date, basis is no more 20, minus 20. Basis has weakened to minus 32. As you recall, we discussed that when a basis sits from less negative to more negative, it is treated as a weakening of the basis. So basis has weakened. So because of that, basis has changed, and with the change basis, this particular trader received 1 rupees for first 4 days and paid margin at a subsequent time period, and net resulting in a net receipt of 2 rupees from margin. And what is the prevailing price? Prevailing price is 90 rupees in the market, and his net receipt is going to be 90 minus 2 is 88 rupees. So even if he has contracted the futures price, he is not getting futures price, he is not even getting the spot price which is prevailing in the market. In fact, he is getting the spot price, but after adjusting for the for the margin payment, his net receipt is going to be less than the spot price prevailing in the market. So this gives rise to the this is the basis risk. Now let's go to the next combination. Similarly, you have a contango market. Basis is basis changes on the contract squaring update. Basis is from minus 20, it is minus 14. So in this case, basis has strengthened. If you remember, strengthening of basis means from more negative to less negative. So from minus 20 to minus 14 is treated as a strengthening of the basis. So when basis has strengthened, let's see what is happening. His total receipt is not 90, his total receipt is 90 plus 16, that is coming to your 106. Again, let me repeat, this 106 can also be arrived at F0. That is the futures price prevailing on the contract initiation date and the basis prevailing on the contract squaring of date. So that is your 120 minus 14, that comes to 106. So I have just also taken similarly different combination. So you will have you have you know spot price 100, futures price 20, contango market basis is minus 20, but on the contract expiry date, contract you know the basis has you know weakened from minus 20 to minus 21. So going by that, how much is going to be the net receipt? 110. He will be selling the underlying at 110, but he has already paid 11 rupees as the margin. So net receipt is going to be 99 rupees. So similarly, you have other combinations. Basis is 20 and basis changed to 17. So it is weakening of the basis. Weakening of the basis means he has already paid 13 rupees as margin payment. He will be selling the underlying at 110, but net receipt is going to be 97. Now let's go to other combinations. So you have 110 minus 32 gives rise to 78 as your net receipt. This is also 80 minus the basis prevailing on the contract square of date. 80 minus 2 is 72. Similar, this is also an extreme case. So you can have a case like, let's say you have 110 is the spot price prevailing on the contract contract squaring of date. So the without the futures contract, this party would have been able to sell the underlying asset at 110, but because it has entered into futures contract, it has already paid a mark to market margin of 50 rupees. So his net receipt from the contract is a 60 rupees. So why it has resulted, why this has happened? Basis has shifted from the 20 basis, it has gone down to minus 20. So the movement of basis, let's summarize from this particular Excel, you will be able to see that is the receipt, the actual receipt by a short hedger on the contract expiry date, contract square of date, the day it is interested to take the physical undertake the physical transaction of selling the underlying asset in the spot market and squaring of the contract before the maturity. So the net receipt could be substantially different depending upon how the basis has changed over time period. So this gives rise to a risk called basis risk. So similar exercise can be done for a long hedger. So this Excel file which I showed it to you, it's pertaining to the basis risk faced by a short futures holder or short hedger. Exactly the same thing can be done for a long futures position holder. Now let's go to another example. Let's see. A soya oil producer crosses soybean and produces refined soya oil. So it intends to sell the first lot of soya oil, which is around 14 metric ton, on 10th June 2016. So his physical transaction date, the day he will be actually selling the soya oil at the prevailing spot price in a local market, let's say Indore, that is on 10th June 2016. So it is fearing that price will go down and hence it enters into a short futures contract at a price of 870 per 10 kg for second month futures contract, which is maturing on 20th June. So let me write down. You have spot date is 22nd April 2016 and contract maturity date is 20th June 2016. Square update, the day the date is your that is your 10th June 2016. So on the spot date it enters into the contract. So on spot date it enters into a contract F0T as 870. So on the on 10th June 2016 it squares up the contract . So it had taken earlier, it had taken a long, sorry, it had taken a short futures contract. It's so, so total receipt on 10th June will be the price at which he will be selling the you know underlying at the local market, that is the spot price prevailing on the this date. So let's name it as ST. It also it had agreed it had agreed to receive F0, and it is also, when it is squaring up its contract, it has agreed to pay FT. So net receipt, so total receipt on 10-0 is going to be ST plus F0 minus FT. So what we can write it as F0 plus ST minus FT. So that is going to be F0 plus PT. So total receipt for a short hedger is going to be F0 plus BT. So depending upon how the BT is moving, the trader may get more money than the F0, or trader may get less money than the F0. So this is what we discussed, is basis risk from the short futures point of view. Similarly, if we have a long hedger, a party who is short on underlying, or who is a consumer and he would like to take long futures position, so his total payment will be, so he will be buying the underlying at the spot market by paying ST. He also had taken a long futures position, so he agreed to pay F0. So you will have, the payment is going to be, so long futures position total payment is going to be ST plus F0 minus FT. So you will have, it is same thing as F0 plus ST minus FT, which is equal to F0 plus BT. So let me repeat here. The long hedger payment, let me focus on the word total payment, because in case of a short hedger it was total receipt, but in case of a long hedger it is going to be total payment. So total payment is going to be S0 plus F0 minus FT. So this is nothing but F0 sorry, it will be st plus f0 minus ft. So it is f0 plus st minus ft. So this is comes to f0 plus basis on t. So this, let me summarize that in case of a futures contract, commodity traders are exposed to the basis risk, and basis risk emanates from the way the spot and futures price move with each other. If spot and futures price do not move in a similar manner, then the traders are exposed to the basis risk. So I'm winding up this particular session on basis risk. In the next session, we will be not only discussing little more on basis risk, we will also go to understanding what are the different hedge ratio and how many contracts a trader should buy or sell to mitigate its exposure in the underlying market. Thank you all of you. Looking forward to meeting you all again in the next session.